Good evening, all of you. So today's last topic is destructors in C++. What do you mean by a destructor in C++? We have seen constructor in our previous session. Destructor is also a special member function in C++ because its name is same as that of the class name. But the job of destructor is exactly reverse of constructor method. A destructor, as the name implies, is used to destroy the objects that have been created by the constructor method. Like constructor, the destructor is a member function whose name is same as that of the class name, but it is preceded by a tilde symbol. For example, the destructor for the class integer can be defined as given below. If you see this line, this is the destructor for the constructor method for the class integer. There is a small difference between the constructor definition and destructor definition. If you see, it is preceded by the tilde symbol here. So you can identify destructor methods, all the destructor methods, by tilde symbol at the beginning. A destructor never takes any argument, nor does it return any value to the caller. It will be invoked implicitly by the compiler upon exit from the program or a block or a function, as the case may be, to clean up the storage that is no longer needed or no longer accessible. It is a good practice to declare destructors in a program, since it releases memory space for future use. So, there is a difference between a constructor and destructor. The job of the constructor method is to create the object, assigns the values to the object. It means it constructs the objects. But whereas destructor works in reverse order of their constructor, its job is to destroy the objects created by the destructor method. Now we'll see a small program on working of constructor and destructor in C++. Consider a code like this: integer count equal to 0. This variable is responsible for counting the number of objects created by the constructor method. There is a class alpha where we have a constructor method written like this. In the constructor method, we just incrementing the count value here, and it displays this line. Next line displays the value of the count. There is another method defined here. In this method, there is a tilde symbol before alpha. It means it is a destructor method. Here we are going to first display the number of the object destroyed, and then once it is destroyed, we'll decrement the counter by 1. Here we close the class and we write the main function. In the main program, when you enter, first of all we need to create the object of the class. So here this line creates a1, a2, a3 and a4 objects. After this line, there is a block. When we enter into the block, this line shows that we are in block 1. And next line create another object, A5. Now whenever we comes to the closing bracket of the block, the destructor gets activated. We have created 5 objects till now, till this line. And whenever you comes to the closing bracket of a block, a function or a program, automatically the destructor gets activated. Now we created the objects A1, A2, A3, A4 and A5, correct? The recent object created was A5. So destructor works into the reverse order of the constructor. So it finds A5 is the object in front, and it destroys object A5. So at the end of creation of A5 object, the count was 5. Then you came to the closing bracket of this block and it destroyed, destructor gets activated and it destroyed object A5, it means again the counter becomes 4. Object A5 gets deleted from the memory. Means at the end of this first closing bracket of the first block, the count was 4 again. Now you entered into the next block, second block. This line will display the message that you entered into the second block. Here you created another object A6. So it increments the counter to 5 again from 4. But when you came to the closing bracket of the second block, again the destructor get activated and it now destroy object number A6 and again your counter becomes 4. In the next line, if you see, again you re-enter into the main program, it successfully executes return 0 also. Now when you go to the closing bracket of the program, again the destructor get activated and is destroy the remaining objects in the reverse order of their creation. It means now A4 gets deleted, then A3, then A2, and at last it deletes A1 object. So if you see in the output also, you'll come to know that constructor works into the forward direction whereas destructor works into the reverse direction. See, this is the output of that program. When we entered into the main program, we created 4 objects. So it shows you the number of the object created was 1, 2, 3 and 4. Then you entered into the first block. Again you created one object, A5 object there. It shows that the number of the object created is 5. But when you came to the closing bracket of the first block, destructor get activated and it destroyed the object number 5. After closing bracket of the first block, you enter into the next block, block number 2. There you created object number 6 and you are again the object number created is 5, because when you close the first block the count was 4 and when you created object number 6 again the count becomes 5. When you came to the second block closing bracket, there again the destructor get activated and it destroyed the object A6 and again your counter get decremented by 1. So the number of the object destroyed was 5. Then you re-enter into the main program and after successfully executing the program, when it comes to the closing bracket of the program, the remaining objects gets deleted in the reverse order of their construction. That is, first object number 4 gets destroyed, then third, then second and then first object gets destroyed. It means that the constructor works in the forward direction whereas destructor works in the reverse direction of the construction of objects. So this ends the topic on destructors in C++. If you have any doubts, you can ask me now. By raising or clicking the hand raise button, you can ask me the question on destructors in C++. In the exam, they may ask you a question on difference between constructor and destructors also for 5 marks in short notes. Any doubts? Yes. Pankaj. Hello. Yes. Remember one thing, user do not have right to call a destructor. Destructors are automatically invoked by the compiler, executed by the compiler upon reaching of closing bracket of a block, closing bracket of a function or closing bracket of a program. We never call the destructor method and constructor method. They are invoked automatically by the compiler when you reach to the closing bracket of block, function or a program. Is it clear? And the job of the destructor is to just clean the memory occupied by the objects of the class. Constructor is responsible for creating the object whereas destructor is responsible for destroying the objects. Any other doubts that you have? Okay, thank you. Thank you very much for watching this video. Now this ends your session on destructors in C++.